This is the Wyze app for the Wyze OG and Wyze OG Telephoto. The application itself is actually very similar for the two. There's a few features that the OG has that the OG Telephoto does not have, but I will let you know when we get to parts that are telephoto related versus just plain OG related. I will also state that in a lot of areas, once we get in here, I'm actually utilizing a Cam Plus subscription on the OG and not on the OG Telephoto. One of the more radical design changes that you're going to notice for the OG and OG Telephoto is, well, the menu structure down here has greatly changed in comparison to previous Wyze Cam products. And this over here, this little free floating arrow. What is that? If I tap on that, that actually is a live view from my other camera. In this case, this is for my OG Telephoto. And while tapping twice to bring it up kind of shows you what's going on. Granted, this is kind of done at night, so it's not the greatest, but you get an idea that the telephoto right here is zoomed in on this portion of a tree, kind of showing you what the night vision mode looks like. I just did this a little too late to show you what the colored night vision looks like. However, because the OG telephoto is focused in on something, the colored night vision needs a lot more. So like this one here, coming back to the other camera, this stayed color much longer. Here's a quick example of what the difference between the OG regular and the OG telephoto looks like. We do have this in large screen mode, but if I pull it up over here, both these cameras are facing out my back window. So this right here is the view that the OG has. Notice how it has a wider field of view, and then same location, we bring it over to the telephoto and you can see it's zoomed in on this hedge line here. And you can see a little bit right there and there, which is kind of what I wanted. And you can see a pile of rocks back there. And if we pop this over again to the OG, not the telephoto, you can see that's right over there. So even if I zoom in on the OG, I can still see that, but you can kind of tell it's getting blurry. But if we pop over again to the telephoto, you can see it's kind of the same view as if I zoomed in, but with the telephoto, I can zoom in even closer. So here, I can kind of get into that rock pile that my neighbor's piling up back there, and then I can kind of get really close to the bushes and see individual twigs and branches, and that's the big difference between the telephoto and the OG. Now, one of the things is you might notice, hey, this is a little free-floating thing. I could put this wherever I want it to go, which is kind of nice. The one thing, and if I tap this X, I can unlink. We're gonna say no, because I don't wanna unlink it. One thing that I don't particularly care for the free-floating nature of this is, if I put it down here, I wish that when I came back to the application, it would leave it down there. By default, it will always show up back up there, regardless of which camera you go to. Tapping on our image will give us a lot of information. Over here, we can see that we are currently recording in HD. Tapping that, I can drop it down to standard def, and then drop it down to 360 if I want it, and back up to HD. You'll notice that the readout right there is going to change the bit rate, letting you know how much data you're actually using. You have a live right there, letting you know this is a live feed from the camera. Over here, we have the ability to tap on this and it will make this large screen view. So like this. This again is one of the things that I don't particularly care about with the camera itself, is the way that it handles the large view and zooming. Before, you could double tap and it would bring you in. Now you pinch to zoom and notice the image itself on the screen isn't getting bigger, but rather it's bringing you closer in. So I would have to either rotate my screen to make this full screen, or use that button right up there. You'll also notice that I have to pinch out to zoom all the way out again, as opposed to in the past where you could just double tap once you got to the full zoom extension and that would bring you all the way out. Again, not sure how I feel about that, but you can also see, since I went out of the camera and came back, my arrow moved back up here and I'm gonna put it back down there because that's where I want it to be. Back to the left-hand side here, for the Wyze Cam OG, not on the telephoto, we have an option to turn on the light. Now, this is kind of in a window right now, so it's gonna reflect back at us. But here, ooh, it did a quick color night vision grab because it thought there was enough light and then toggled itself off. Now we have our microphone. Turning that on will allow me to speak through the camera. Notice also that the volume is turned on so that you can hear anything that's being said on the other end. I'm gonna tap that off and it'll automatically mute itself. If I want to, I could just unmute so that I can hear the audio from the camera itself. And I'm gonna tap that back. Now, there is more to do here. You'll notice there's this little slider here. Well, look at that. It required me to drag it down before it zoomed into full screen mode. And then even then, I have to pinch and move around. I do have all the camera controls that I had before, but now I have it on a larger screen and I still have access to that secondary window for the telephoto or whatever other camera I have linked to this. And I'm gonna hit back, which brings me back here. And this again is part of the frustration with this new design, which has specific elements for the OG and OG telephoto only. If I come down and show the menu, this is gonna give us access to a lot of things that were more accessible before. Right here we have SD card. Selecting SD card will show me all the recordings I have on this SD card and a timeline going across here. If there were any notable events, they would show up here as long as you had a Wyze Cam subscription. So if I come to Saturday, I have a complete timeline. I can select go live. I could select any date I want there. I also have the ability to select calendar and whichever date I want, I could go, okay, do this date here, save, and that will load in that date. Notice there's nothing available. I can select go live, or within this window, I can take a photo if there was something happening, record if there was something that I could record, and then go to album. And the album's gonna be my saved photos, my saved videos, and then any time lapse. And coming back from here, I can select go live, and that brings me back to my live video. Right here, I could take a photo just like I could on the other page. I can also record, and that will record live. I have the ability to access the siren. Selecting the siren will give you a siren sound, letting people know maybe they shouldn't be here. Album, just like before, we could access our album where all those things are saved. And then we have time lapse. Selecting time lapse will allow you to create a time lapse using this camera where it takes single images that it stitches together and makes it into a video that you can watch. And here it's even giving you an estimate of how long it'll be, 16 seconds, and it'll take 30 megabytes. Keep in mind, if you're going to use time lapse, you do need to have an SD card in the camera. It does not save this particular functionality to the cloud. We also have the ability right here to turn off the camera. If I select this, the camera is no longer recording and will not be viewable by you until you come back and turn on the camera. This page, which it takes a little bit of time before it shows up here. So I can turn it on there, or I can come into the camera, open my menu, and come on to turn it on or turn it on from up here. I'm going to select turn on. We'll give it a moment to resituate itself and then come down. We're gonna collapse the menu that was hidden. And here we have events. So right now there are no people events, but there would be a little icon there letting you know, hey, I saw a person. Right now it's letting me know, hey, I saw a bunch of motion events. I can come over here to the filter icon and select what I wanna see from this. Now, the events here is because I have a Cam Plus subscription on this. If I select for this and select person and then hit save, I'm not gonna see anything until I find one that has a person in it. This is really good because I can come in here and say, oh, it's a motion event or it's a person. I can click on it. It will show me exactly what it was. It'll show me what was triggered. That's pretty good. I can go back to live by selecting that. But let's say you don't have a Cam Plus subscription. And right now my telephoto does not. So what happens is you get this, a motion detection. Notice that image over there in the corner? That's letting you know, hey, I took a still frame. There's something that happened at 625. Well, what does that mean? That means if I have a micro SD card in here, I have to go to show, come over to SD card, and then try to scrub for around 625 to see if I can find what set that off. This is where, while yes, you can use the cameras without a Cam Plus subscription, it becomes difficult to do so, especially if you're using this for capturing people or what have you. I'm gonna bring this back around to the OG, not the OG telephoto. Like I said, we can scrub through this and it will show us all the motion events. There are no people in my backyard at the moment, but the image or little depictions next to these would show any one of these filter items, motion, sound, person, package, pet, and vehicle, as long as you have the subscription service. And that is everything that we can do camera control wise and recording wise for the Wyze Cam OG and Wyze Cam telephoto. But if we come up to the top here, this is where we start getting into the settings. Right here you could see the OG has the Cam Plus subscription because it's indicated there. If I did not have that and I come over and I switch to the live stream of my telephoto, you'll notice it has the get right there. So we're gonna swap back one more time and you can see how seamless it is to do that. I like that. I just wish that while this was free floating, pin it somewhere where I tell it to stay. Moving on to the right, we have our settings sprocket. Selecting this will bring us into our settings menu. Right here, we're gonna start at the top. You can see I have a name. You can change that if you want simply by tapping this. You have several predefined names right there, or you can type one in of your own. I'm gonna select back, and we're gonna come into detection settings. Right here, we have the ability to make the motion sensitivity of our pixel-based camera more sensitive or less sensitive. I have it about 72, that is what works for me. You have detection zones. Right now I have this turned off, but if we turn this on, hypothetically, if I only care about this particular area over here, this is the only thing that I want to get motion alerts for. This will allow me to highlight a specific area and then tell it, hey, only there. The beauty of this grid system is, let's say I want to monitor these two spaces. Well, if I had a box or a drag and drop, I couldn't have large gaps of space without dropping another area box, which depending on how many you get, you might run out of them. So here I could say do this one, do this here, and do this here in the middle. So right there, five unique areas that I can monitor this way. If you want to get rid of something you saw, just run your finger over it again like I was doing, or you could hit clear and it gets rid of everything. Once you're done, you can either save if you've got a selection, or you can turn it off like I will be doing and going back. Motion tagging, those motion events that you saw with the green box around them, that is what motion tagging is. I like that feature. It lets me know, hey, pay attention to this area because something has happened and you probably should look at what's going on. Sound detection sensitivity, if you're using the camera to pick up audio cues and then alert you of those, this is how you slide for sensitivity. Coming back, we have event recordings. Notice both event recordings and notifications have the plus next to them. That means that there are some features in here, which I will point out, that are only accessible if you have a Cam Plus subscription. Selecting event recordings, we're gonna come into here. I have detects motion and detects sound. I have just detect sound turned off. Smart detections, this is what you need the subscription service for. Selecting this will allow you to say, hey, I want person, I want pet, I want vehicle, I want package. Friendly faces is a higher level of Cam Plus, but if you had it, you could have a smart AI only notify you when it doesn't detect somebody who's part of your family unit. I'm gonna select back and then come over to notifications. I have my notifications completely turned off, but if I turn this on, I can select motion events, and then based on having Cam Plus, I can say person, pet, vehicle, package, or all other motion. If I do all other motion, I would just get every little bit of movement. Now, with the OG cameras, you do not have access to the Cam Plus Lite subscription, which would let you do a pay your own price for person detection. You will, if you want to have person detection, need a Cam Plus subscription. Selecting back, we have our alarm settings. Smoke alarm turned on. I should also probably turn on carbon monoxide. What this will do is, this will turn your camera into a pseudo smoke detector and carbon monoxide detector smart device. In the US, there is a specific T4 alarm sound that you have with both the CO and smoke alarms. And if your camera hears it, it will send you a notification saying, I hear a smoke detector going off. And then you can open up your camera and look and see what's going on and figure out how to address it. Coming back, we have our advanced settings. And right here we have record to micro SD card. You need to have a micro SD card in there. You can toggle that on and off. You have continuous recording or you have event recordings. I have it continuous, meaning 24/7, it is recording to the SD card. If I select manage, this lets me know, hey, this is how much is being used. So you can see it's pretty much full and will rewrite itself, getting rid of the oldest. I can format this and clear everything off of this at once, or I can eject this to take it safely out of my camera. Here we have night vision mode, auto, on, and off. If I select off right now, that means it will take it out of night vision mode. So if I come back here, you'll kind of get an idea. There's the color night vision as it tries to see what's going on. I've got a couple lights turned on out there just so I could see and make sure it was working correctly for you. We're gonna come back up to settings, come to advanced, and then I'm gonna turn it back to auto. So I can either turn night vision on, have it on all the time, or I can turn it off completely. Camera status light, this is important if you're going to have the camera in sleep mode. I recommend leaving the status light on so that you know, hey, the camera is asleep and not actually watching me anymore. Night vision IR lights, again, I appreciate that Wyze allows you to turn these on and off because right now I have it facing out of a window. If I had the IR lights on, it would bounce all that back into the camera itself and it would look horrible. So the ability to toggle that on and off is great. Moving down, we have our timestamp watermark. So that little time that you saw in the corner, we have rotate image 180 degrees? Well, if you mount this camera upside down, you're gonna wanna have the image be right side up for you. In order to do that, you rotate your image 180 degrees and use this toggle right here. Show the Wyze logo if you wanted to. Having the Wyze logo show up in your little left-hand corner there lets you know where the image came from. In my case, since I have quite a few cameras, I like to leave that on so I know where something came from. And then record sound, toggle on and off. In some states in the US, it is illegal to capture video with audio, so you could turn that off if you wanted to right from here. And then you have your sync time. Selecting this will sync to your local time on your cell phone and push that to the camera. Spotlight settings, as you might imagine, is only for the OG camera, not the OG telephoto. Turning this on, I could say, hey, turn my spotlight on, and it will turn the spotlight on. So notice, enabling the setting will automatically turn on the spotlight when the camera detects motion. So if you don't want to have to manually trigger the spotlight to look at something, this is how you do that. And then if it gets a motion event, it will automatically turn the light on. Again, because I have the camera facing out of a window, I have that functionality turned off because it would just blind the camera. Coming down, we have rules, which will allow you to set up specific trigger times and things that you can do, such as only have the camera record between this time and this time, or if a person is detected, turn on my Wyze light bulb or turn off my Wyze smart plug. Sharing will allow you to share the device with another person. They will need their own Wyze account in order to be able to use this feature. You have device info, which will give you sensitive information about your device. You have Wyze support, which is built in right here, which is great. So if you have problems, you could select that and it'll tell you anything you need to know. Device info is also where you'd look and find firmware updates for the camera. You have a restart camera, which I just did by tapping that, which will restart the camera. And then you have delete this device. So if you wanted to remove it from your application, you could. I'm gonna select back and that's still rebooting. So we're gonna pop over to the telephoto really quick and come into the settings. Just so you can see that the only difference is the fact that it's missing that spotlight option. Everything else is exactly the same. Coming back to our main page here, I'm gonna quickly discuss the bottom here of the Wyze app in case you've never seen the Wyze application before, because we covered all the settings already for both the cameras. Home, that's gonna list out all of your cameras. If you're getting the OG, you probably are getting the OG telephoto and OG as a bundle. So home will list them both out and give you ability to toggle them on and off. Events, this is going to group all of your events in one location. So right here you could see there was a motion event. There's from the telephoto, that's a picture that it took, so a little less useful. You have the ability up here to move through a calendar. You can say, hey, just show me people. Notice there's no people right now. I can select motion. I can select what camera I want by clicking right there. We're gonna go back. We have monitoring. So if you have Wyze's monitoring service, this is where you can come to see all that information. If you don't have that service, it'll prompt you to purchase that service. Shopping tab at the bottom will always let you know, hey, these are the latest and greatest things that Wyze has coming out. Maybe you want to look through this and purchase something. Right here, you could see they have the stack kit for the Wyze cameras. So right now I don't have the stack kit, but if I needed to, I can come into the shopping and select it right here. This is going to have all of your account information. So across all of your Wyze cameras, here you could see it's saying, hey, Cam Plus, video length. It's letting you know, hey, it's a good thing that you're paying for Cam Plus. If you didn't have Cam Plus, it will show you up here. Here's the motion events that you've missed. Account, that's gonna show personal information, but about your account. Home, you can have several different home locations set up, so you can manage them from there. Services, again, this is going to be managing your Cam Plus subscriptions. Security, just as it sounds, is security. Sharing across all of your cameras, not just a single one. Notifications, again, across all the cameras. Firmware update, I like this because I can come in here and say, hey, do any of my cameras or anything I have need a firmware? And it shows me everything's up to date, which is great. Smart integration, that's going to be with your Google Home and Alexa. So you will be able to view live feeds if you have smart devices with screens that support that. Rules, again, across all of your devices, community, support, and then app settings, and then about. And that has been everything that you can do in the Wyze application for both the Wyze Cam OG and the Wyze Cam OG telephoto.